The Elder Scrolls. It all began here, with the Elder Scrolls Arena. I am Amethyst Lunatari, and this is just a little introductory video discussing the game and the way I'm going to be playing the game and the improvements I've installed. So this is basically like the prelude to the actual game. So there's going to be no gameplay here, no character creation. None of that. That will be in the next video. I want to thank my patrons on Patreon: Sentimange, Sophie Hamilton, Akatemo, Andy Semler, and Boy Flea. Hope I pronounced those correctly. If not, my apologies. Yeah, so I'm just gonna be talking about this. Some of you may choose to skip past this video. However, you might have questions that would be answered in this video, so keep in mind I've never played past the first dungeon, but I have done a lot of research on this game, so I can't really call it a blind let's play, but it is my first playthrough of the game. I have wandered around the first dungeon, have not actually left the dungeon to the shift gate or even found the shift gate. So basics of this game, for people who may not be familiar, unlike other Elder Scrolls games, there are no skills here. There are 8 stats, which you improve as you level up. Strength, intelligence, wisdom, etc. It's all very Dungeons and Dragons-like. There's no real lore to speak of, just as far as the emperors and... And that's it, really. Well, from what I understand, the Dark Brotherhood and the Thieves Guild are in this game, as well as several other guilds, but you cannot join them. The Dark Brotherhood, they're just enemies for you to fight. There are no orcs that you can play as, they're just enemies for you to fight. There are no Daedra as such. Well, I guess they are Daedra, but they call them demons, not Daedra. And the interesting thing is that you can visit basically every province in the game, which is the only Elder Scrolls game to be able to say that. And we're going to be going to all the provinces throughout this game. Side quests are random, like Radiant quests in Skyrim, believe it or not. Go to this dungeon, get me this thing, escort this NPC over here, go across town to talk to this person, you know, and you get a small reward. The only quest that's actually written in stone, handcrafted, is the main quest. And the non-main quest dungeons are random, procedurally generated. The main quest dungeons are handcrafted, for the most part, I understand. The main quest has you going after 8 pieces of the Staff of Chaos. You first have to go to one dungeon to find out where the piece is. So you have to find a piece of the Elder Scroll, or you have to find a map or something like that, and then bring it back to the ruler of that province. And then the ruler will say, ah, I can see here on the Elder Scroll it says that the staff piece is in blankety blank. So then you have to go to that dungeon. So, 8 pieces, 2 dungeons each, that's 16 dungeons. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The Imperial Province, I don't know if there's a dungeon, but I know the game ends there. So 16 dungeons at least. The only other things, like, basically you can explore whatever dungeon you want, explore whatever town you want, but that's if you want to basically grind for cash, levels, items, what have you. The only ones I can see that are worth it, unless I want to, you know, actually grind, like I said, are the artifact quests. The artifacts, there are quite a few of them. You can only have one at a time, unless you cheese the system, which I will not do. You can cheese the system by giving the artifact to a blacksmith to be repaired, so then you no longer physically have the item. He's holding on to it for a certain amount of days or something like that, and then you can go look for another artifact. So you can cheese it that way, but I'm not going to do that. One notable artifact is the Agma Infinium, which gives you 50 extra stat points, which is awesome, and you can look for that. You can go get that as many times as you want, because once you use it and distribute your stat points, that's it. It's gone from your inventory, so you can go get it again. Other interesting artifacts are the Staff of Magnus, which we saw in Skyrim, the Necromancer's Amulet, the Ring of Finaster, and for mage types, which I'm going to be playing, those appeal to me. They have various powers, regenerating health, mana, immune to certain effects, and such like that. So, an interesting thing, just want to note, back in 94 or 95, whenever, I saw Arena, a box copy of Arena in Electronics Boutique or similar store. Funny thing is, I thought it was like just a gladiator-style combat game. So I passed it up. I'm like, oh, looks vaguely interesting, but I'm gonna suck at this because it looks like a fighting game, like Mortal Kombat or something like that, only taking place in a medieval or fantasy-style arena. And the funny thing is, that's not even ironic, because the game was originally going to be that. It was going to be a gladiator-style combat game where you started off as a prisoner and you fought to, you know, gain your freedom or get riches and fame or both. And they decided to add side quests, dungeons, other RPG elements, and they decided that the stuff they were adding was a lot more fun than the gladiator style combat. So they decided to make it into a full-fledged RPG with a giant world and everything like that. And they took out the gladiator arena combat. And the thing is that the box art and the promo material is already done. So they decided to basically just slap the Elder Scrolls on top of it to try to help people see that it was an RPG game, and that did not work for me. I still thought it was a gladiator-style combat game, because it really looked like it was. So the other interesting thing is that, well, yeah, I don't even remember what the hell I was going to say. Right. Arena. They try to explain away the whole arena by saying that the land of Tamriel is so, you know, dangerous, and there's monsters and bandits and enemies all over the place. That's like living in an arena. So you'll see them refer to Tamriel as the arena in this game from time to time. And future installments, they basically just forgot about that. No, it was never called Arena. What are you talking about? Anyway, so that is the basics of the game. Details I'll go over as I play or as I discover it myself, because I did a lot of research, but I'm sure there's some things that I haven't found out. Now, how I'm going to be playing this game? Well, it is sort of blind, because like I said, it's my first time playing, but I've done a lot of research, so I know the basic gist of things, how things are going to go. I'm going to show you guys the main quest only, with one, probably two artifact quests. I'm gonna go look for the Augman Finium first, and then go find one of those other artifacts that I mentioned that are good for mages. And I'll probably leave that in. If I decide to grind for levels or cash, I'd probably leave that out. So this is one of the only, or the only Elder Scrolls game where you just see me play the main quest. Because normally, you guys know me, I play every quest available, but you can keep on going and going with quests forever in Arena because it's Radiant quests and it never ends. I read all the things except for repeat dialogue, like random things that just, I guess, are boring to read because, I don't know, telling you that the date and all that stuff. You'll see. Playing this in full screen. There's no stretching. You see, I'm keeping the 4:3 aspect ratio. I do apologize for the thing in the corner. The bottom left-hand corner. There's nothing really I can do about that. Otherwise, I'll have to play in a window. So, I really don't feel like playing in a window. I feel like, you know, I'll become the most immersed if I play in full screen like this. So hopefully it doesn't bother anybody. It is off to the side, so it won't appear over, you know, the game itself. Normally, that indicator, which shows that I'm recording, which is good to know, normally that indicator is just not there, you know what I'm saying? It's not visible to people. I can see it, but for whatever reason, it's visible here, so I do apologize. Improvements. Made quite a bit of improvements where you can hear the, for anyone familiar with the original theme, this is much improved. I'm using sound fonts, which is basically a software and what they call a sound font installed. I'm using Virtual MIDI Synth. Runs on your computer, and then you run, I'm running the Arachno sound font. Basically, for those who don't know, MIDI is not really, it's not actual music in itself, it's a set of instructions for the computer to play music. It's really the instruments that make it sound like this, or make it sound like, you know, how tinny, like default MIDI sound actually is. So we're using much better instrument sounds here with the Arachno sound font, and Virtual MIDI Synth is the one who is basically playing the MIDI files through the sound font, if that makes any sense. I don't know how else to explain it. The Munt emulator, which emulates MT32 Roland sound card, sounds great in other games. It sounded great for Eye of the Beholder 3, and I think I played it in, I think I used it in Star Trek, either 25th Anniversary or Judgment Rites. It sounds horrible with this game. I don't know why. I messed with it. I did everything I could. It was horrible. So as far as the DOSBox conf file, you can set a CONF file. You can set various things. I set the scaler to normal 3x, up from normal 2x, so it should look a little better. I try to get the 2x SAI working. It either made the screen, like the viewable graphics here, a lot smaller, or just wouldn't work at all. So this is as good as I can get, I think, unless I go into a window, which I don't plan on doing. Cycles I have is fixed 20,000, and mem size is 64. Otherwise, basically everything else in the conf file has been unaltered except for me changing it to full screen. I am using two mods, quote unquote. I guess you can call them mods in loose term of the word. You can find them both on the Nexus. I'll put links to all these things, to the virtual MIDI synth and to the Nexus here. These two things, sound patch, which removes the clicking sounds from sound effects. I don't know why the sound effects are like that by default, but like when you swing your sword, you can hear a click in the middle of it. Sounds horrible. So I have a sound patch installed that, he basically redid this. He basically edited the sound effects so that those clicking sounds are not present. Very much appreciated. And TES Arena remapped, which changes the keys around to things that make sense. Like for instance, a lot of people want to use WASD controls. And by default in Arena, it's the arrow keys and the mouse, so which are both all on the right side of your, you know, your playing area. But this is back before WASD was a standard. Even the original Doom used arrow keys, pretty sure. So this remaps that, so you can use WASD, and basically to jump is Shift J. This changes that, so you just press space and you can jump. So that's what I have installed, and I look forward to playing this all for you guys, and you're gonna have a lot of fun, and hope I don't die too many times and get lost too many times. Anyway, see you guys in the Let's Play. Always seek adventure.